Welcome back to GMA3, everybody. We continue our Year of You in 22 series. It's inevitable now. We have a new year. A lot of people are setting health and diet goals.
That's right. But how do you make those goals truly attainable? Well, Alicia Quarles is here with how you can start this year off on the right foot. Hey, Alicia.
Hello, Amy. Hello, TJ. Happy New Year. So, guys, I don't know about you, but for me, keeping resolutions is so hard. But thanks to our sponsor, MyFitnessPal, I had a chance to speak with a nutritionist who showed me how to make all of our wellness goals a little bit easier this year.
Well, Erin, it's 2022, which means kicking off some wellness goals. What's something that would surprise us about our approach to wellness this year?
A lot of people think they're doing the right things when actually what they're doing can be having a negative impact on them. If you are doing a crash diet and you're dramatically restricting your calories, you're gonna start to feel really fatigued and it might impact your mood and even sleep. Or if you try to jump all in with a new workout routine, you could end up injured if you don't ease into it.
All right, let's talk about the dreaded D word, diet. What are some do's and don'ts when it comes to dieting?
The big thing to think about is if you're gonna be following a diet, ask yourself, is this actually something I can stick with long-term? The most important thing is that you understand that what you put into your body, what you eat, it impacts everything. And that's why it is so important to track what you are eating and keep a food record. With an app like MyFitnessPal, it's incredibly easy to do. It's a free app. It's actually the number one nutrition and food tracking app and has over 200 million members. The reason it's so popular and so great is because they have this database of over 14 million foods. So you know exactly what you're putting into your body.
Well, obviously we made it through the holidays. It's the dead of winter though, and my energy is shot. What can I do to get it back?
We're never gonna know exactly what's impacting our energy if we don't keep track. You know, that's why I love to say, keep track, use your MyFitnessPal, and see these trends. You'll notice, oh my gosh, that was the day that I didn't drink enough water, or maybe I had too much added sugar. If you're going more plant-based, and I know that's a big trend this year, one nutrient you really wanna pay attention to is vitamin B12. This converts food into energy, but the thing about vitamin B12 is we find it mostly in animal products. Now, a really, really simple solution is just go pick up some nutritional yeast. It's right in the grocery store. It's a vegan source of B12, and it's so easy to just sprinkle. You can put it right on yogurt, soups, salads, but a great way to pack in that vitamin that can really help with energy.
Well, days like today when I have brain fog, I just went for what was quick. It was tea instead of grabbing fruit like I should have. But you have a tip that I never even thought of.
The number one thing you want to do when it comes to focus is actually organize. Organize your refrigerator and your pantry. If there's foods that you want to eat more of to help you focus, if you don't see them, you're not going to eat them. A lot of people reach for soda for that quick burst of caffeine and sugar. I love to do water infused with fruit, put it right at eye level, and then you're more likely to drink it. And same thing with the pantry. Take some whole grain cereal. You can add some nuts and some dried fruit and make a really delicious, like crunchy and sweet trail mix. Put that right at eye level in the pantry. And that way you're eating something that's gonna fill you up, it's gonna satisfy that sweet tooth, but it helps with focus too.
A lot of people are like me and they can relate. You're not sleeping as much when you're busy, you're not eating to eat as much, but I end up hangry. What are your tips for helping my mood?
A lot of times that is because our blood sugar begins to dip. So you wanna eat more frequently, getting adequate protein and fiber. Like if in the morning, let's say you're having a bowl of cereal, don't just have the cereal by itself, but put some nuts on it, and that will help sustain you more. And when you move your body, that releases those feel-good endorphins, it lowers stress hormones. When we see those patterns, we can fix them to feel our best.
Well, Erin, thank you for all of your expertise. Girl, I'm ready to rock it in 2022.
And while you do something good for yourself, you'll be doing good for others as well. For every download of the free MyFitnessPal app in the month of January, they will donate one meal up to 45,000 to those in need through Share the Meal.
That's what I call a win-win, Alicia. Thank you very much for that.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.